Imagine the journey of an undergrad graduate as a very carefully orchestrated edifice of knowledge. Every coursework acts as a brick, and every lab work acts as a beamline. And this capstone thesis, it acts as an overarching crown, which puts everything together. It acts like a keystone, which puts everything stand independently. It's very vital because, unlike structured lab practicals and lab exercises, the capstone presents an open-ended problem, and let's say an array of open-ended problems, which requires critical thinking, independent decision making, and troubleshooting, approaching how you approach a troubleshoot. The students learn to navigate through these uncertainties, which are inherent in research and troubleshooting. And it also helps them build independent decision-making qualities, I think, which is very important. And most importantly, they get to learn from their own mistakes.
To do my research, I went the secondary research route, which means I did a literature review and I looked at over 107 papers. In this process, my faculty mentor, Professor Gautam, has helped me immensely. He has shown constant love, support, and faith. I think that's the most important part. Just letting me know that no matter what approach any of us take, it's the end goal that really matters. And just his faith in my ideas and my way of working recapitulated the idea that, you know, scientific inquiry is not a one-size-fits-all.
Capstone made me realize how two very distinct systems in your body can be so intricately connected, and it piqued my interest in neuroscience more than ever, and this led me to believe that I still want to pursue research in my master's and PhD, potentially in neuroscience.
So because my capstone saw the relationship between two distinct organs that once was not thought to be interconnected, I think viewing the human body as a system that is interconnected instead of individual organs is something that I learned from my capstone. Other than this, research writing and looking into research is also something that I learned because of this capstone.
I have done a lot of tiny research projects throughout my journey at Krea, which helped me tackle my capstone better, I would say, but nothing could have prepared me for the extensiveness of the research that was required for my capstone. Through my capstone, I've learned a certain sense of discipline and dedication that it requires. And I also feel like this is such a small dent in research that you can do, and it's really taught me that research is like a really collaborative and like larger community effort.
At Krea, I believe the capstone experience, we try to enrich it with interwoven learning and ethics, which is also our institution's ethos, and we try to make it interdisciplinary as much as possible. For example, a student from biology can collaborate with a student of computers. The capstone research experience, I think, gives students a realistic glimpse into the complexities and nuances of a research process. The students learn that the research is not linear, setbacks are common, and the perseverance and positive attitude is very, very essential and is the key to the research.